Hey everybody, Rex Bear Leak Project. How the heck are you? I just got some awesome footage of a giant hand on a rock that could be about 1,000, 1,200 years old. And next to it is a six-finger hand, a snake above it. I'm going to show you this in just a moment. And it reminds me of the interview that I had the other day with Daryl Sims, who has incredible testimonies and stories about abductions, encounters with ETs, that are your worst nightmare. So very interesting. I want to thank DJ for sending me this, DJ Ransom. He's got a pretty cool YouTube channel as well. Definitely need to check it out. Make sure to hit the subscribe button as well. And I'm going to show you this video. It's very cool. So he actually did this video real quick. It's just a few seconds. It's like 28 seconds. The highlight of it, he said, hey man, after I heard that interview with Daryl, I realized that image I sent you, there was a giant hand next to the six finger hand. And you know what they say about people with big hands. And you know what they say about people with six fingers. They can type really fast. So, halo, that's what I'm talking about. And check this out, will you? Right now, you have an amazing opportunity to get the coolest flashlight on the planet. And you can get a 70% discount. This is a 2019 model. It is solar powered. And it's got a bank in it. It's got a solar powered charger bank. So you can plug your cell phone or your electronics via USB. And if you've got something picking up sunlight, you don't need any batteries and you can keep your phone charged, etc. It's got a glass breaker. I was about to say an icebreaker. It's got a glass breaker on it. The lumens is 500. That's insane. It's got four different lighting modes. It's got a rope. It has a high low beam option with LED modes and a wire cutter. So go directly to patriotflashlight.com, click the link in the video description box, get the 50% off, and then type in the code LEAK20 for an additional 20% off for a total of 70% off. Now, just to give you an idea real quick, and then we're going to jump into these images. Look at the comparison on the left, the rugged solar-powered flashlight versus the rest, there's no comparison. It's not even in the same league. So, with that said, let's go back. Let's watch this video one more time, and I'm going to show you some incredible pictures out there that are just wild. So, here we go. Giant hand man. And somebody said, do you think that those are drawings on the rock, or do you think that they like dip their hand in something and just put their hand on the rock? I don't think so. I think they're drawings. However, the giant hand could be a handprint, but I certainly think that the six finger hand there is just a drawing in the rock. Pretty cool though, right? Nonetheless, very interesting. So then let's go to this one. Okay, this is the image, and then this right here, see if I can make this a little bit smaller. This one right here is from Daryl Sims. Go to his website, darylsims.com. He's got some incredible information on his website as well. But this is the remains of physical evidence of people that have been abducted or harassed by these beings, whatever they are. Daryl says he thinks they're mainly clones, because they don't have, the ones that he has seen personally, they don't have belly buttons. And he talks about them being different models and having different purposes, almost like sports cars versus utility vehicles. And he brought these props that were made from the physical evidence, the shape and the design. And you can see this six-fingered hand that's enormous next to just a regular hand right there. So a regular adult hand, that's a man hand, next to this very, I mean, what would you call that? Would you call that really manly? I mean, that's, wow. I don't even know what to say. But look at this. Is that a six-toed foot? Interesting shaped foot. This kind of reminds me of a gray just because of the size of the eyes. And the way that it's on a rock that's already shaped somewhat like a gray. or what many people think of as a gray, and people that I know personally that have been abducted multiple times still to this day have encounters. Sometimes they like to talk about it, sometimes they don't. This is an interesting image right here. And this one right here I like because this is the same shape of the ghost beings, the ghost people they're labeled as in the Canyonlands, but it's a very remote place in the Canyonlands in Utah. And this place in Utah that takes hours to get to, you've got to walk there, they estimate over 8,000 years old. Yeah. The exact same design. Now, I don't think this one's 8,000 years old, but it's certainly the exact same design. So what is it? Is it something that they saw in the sky, or was it a being that actually came and visited them? This is an interesting image because this shows the crossing. And I had Diamond on the show a couple weeks ago where he was referencing some material that showcased this wheel and different cycles. Then I want to, this one I like because this makes me think of the Sumerian tablets. So what are they showing us here? What is this, a map? Is this pointing to something? Is it a rocket ship? What does this represent? Now, the Sumerian tablets, this represents Marduk. Marduk is most likely Jupiter. And it might be representing some incredible phenomena that happened a long, long time ago. Tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands, maybe even millions of years ago in the heavens. Then you got the spiral. You've got spirals on both sides here. This one's kind of interesting because it seems to have, I don't know what these links represent on the outside. It's got the four quadrants. Then it's got a triangle on the top. Now, when I was looking at this at first, I was thinking to myself, okay, is that like a headdress? Is that some type of antenna system that this guy's got on? Then I remembered there were petroglyphs of the same design on the top of this guy's head that people think represents the largest mountain or one of the largest mountains in New Mexico. And that entrance or that hallway underneath it is something, it's like a map to the underworld. So this actually, now I think, could be representing these people that came from the underworld, or they came back from the underworld, and this is a map on his head. This is the map of the mountain in New Mexico with the entrance to a catacomb, not hollow earth per se or center of the earth, but definitely hollowed out areas within the earth. And the Hopi prophecy has been talking about this for millennia. So I think that this is representing a map and the people that came from hollow earth. So Marduk, is that Jupiter? Is that a symbol? I don't know what that is. Then the crossing, the spiral, another spiral. This one's very interesting. This looks like a one-eyed being, like a cyclops almost. Look at this guy. Looks like cyclops. Or it's a side view with a giant eyeball. Or it's picking up, like this reminds me a little bit of the Ajiji, the bird people. I really like this one. And before I close out, I want to share some audio of these air traffic control recordings. Like, wow, did you see that? Thing was going fast. They're picking up this stuff on radar that they can't explain. And then the story came out later saying it was space dust. It was space dust. Yeah. It's like, psh, 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 psh. Multiple people saw it. Then they were even like, oh, I'm glad I'm not the only one that saw it. They're like, nope, it wasn't just you. They're like, wow, that was weird. I'll share it with you in a minute. Now, what's this guy doing? He's got some interesting cone-shaped hat on his head. And look at this one. This reminds me of a robot. This reminds me of some type of android type, you know, robotics, machinery. I think this one's really cool, too. And you can see all these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There's 10 dots above him. I don't know what that represents. Here's another interesting petroglyph right there. And Then also, I got this the other day from Annie at the UFO Watchtower. Somebody sent this to her, and they were walking in New Mexico, and you can see clearly the flying saucer right here. That is the standard, traditional textbook. You look it up in the dictionary, what a flying saucer looks like, that's it. So, New Mexico. You gotta love it. You gotta love New Mexico. All right, now let's do this. I wanna share with you the audio. Let's go over here to this audio. I'm gonna play this for you. And here we go.
Section and hello, radar contact. And it seems to be smooth ahead of you as well.
Sounds good, my friend.
Go ahead.
Is there any military traffic you got right now?
Okay, sir, there's nothing showing on either primary or secondary.
Okay, it was moving so fast, it's like you said no longer see it, but yes.
Alongside you?
Yes. Get to 12 on our left-hand side and then rapidly veer to the north. We saw bright light and then it drifted here at a very high speed. We were just wondering. We didn't think it was a likely collision course, we're just wondering what that could have been.
Meteor or another object making some kind of re-entry. Appeared to be multiple objects following the same sort of trajectory. Very bright from where we were.
Okay, that's copied. And is there a direction it was going in or anything? It's copied, thank you.
The Virgin 76 also saw that in our 11 o'clock position. Two bright lights.
Roger, that's copied, thank you.
Glad it wasn't just me.
No, yeah, very interesting that one.
Say again. Hey, thank you.
Virgin 76, I saw two bright lights at 11 o'clock. Seemed to back over to the right and then climb away at speed, at least from our perspective.
Okay, we're passing that on there, thank you.
Speedbird 94, Shannon.
94, go ahead.
Okay, just so you know that other aircraft in the air have also reported the same thing, so we're going to have a look and see. Roger, okay, thank you.
This is smooth again.
Can I take Shannon? Hello, radar contact, and it seems to be smooth ahead of you as well.
Sounds good, my fault.
Go ahead.
Is there any military traffic you got right now?
Okay, sir, there's nothing showing on either primary or secondary.
Okay, it was moving so fast, it's like you can no longer see it, but yes.
Alongside you?
Yes. Get to 12 on our left-hand side and then rapidly veer to the north. We saw bright light and then it drifted here at a very high speed. We were just wondering. We didn't think it was a likely collision course, we're just wondering what that could have been.
Meteor or another object making some kind of re-entry. Appeared to be multiple objects following the same sort of trajectory. Very bright from where we were.
Okay, that's copied. And is there a direction it was going in or anything? It's copied, thank you.
The Virgin 76 also saw that in our 11 o'clock position. Two bright lights.
Roger, that's copied, thank you.
Glad it wasn't just me.
No, yeah, very interesting that one.
Say again. Hey, thank you.
Virgin 76, I saw two bright lights at 11 o'clock. Seemed to back over to the right and then climb away at speed, at least from our perspective.
Okay, we're passing that on there, thank you.
Speedbird 94, Shannon.
Isn't that crazy? Isn't that nuts?
Other aircraft in the air have also reported the same thing, so we're going to have a look and see.
Wild.
Okay, thank you.
Just wild, ladies and gentlemen. So, hey, I mean, air traffic control sees something, they get told it's cosmic dust. You look at the footage that NASA shows that's supposedly from Mars, and all you have to do is change the image like I did earlier. The coloring, as far as, I didn't change even the coloring, just the temperature. You change the temperature to cool. That's it. You don't change anything else on it. And it's so amazing how it goes from looking like a red planet to a blue atmosphere. I mean, it looks like Earth. So it's like, is it Earth? Of course not. Couldn't be. Conspiracy. Why are they hiding it? Or maybe it's got an atmosphere a lot more like Earth. Or maybe all of the above's true and they just don't want to show us what's really out there. Or maybe I'm just a conspiracy theorist and this is all just my opinion. What do you think? What do you think about the hands, though, and the petroglyphs and stuff? That's a trip, right? So let's say that it's about 1,000 years old. Why were they here? What were they doing? What was going on 1,000 years ago? I mean, we know about the cataclysms previous to that, but was there something that happened approximately 1,000 years ago? I've heard of a lot of volcanic activity. I can't wait to hear your thoughts. Thank you for watching. Have an amazing day. Be excellent to each other. Hope to see you at the desert. Currently, it's called the Witness in the Desert, soon to be called the Witness Protection Program in the Desert. Monument Valley. Be the change.